Hi, I'm Achal. Welcome to another course preview of UVdesk ticketing system. Now, automate your process by creating some set of rules and actions to respond faster to the tickets. So, let's have a look over the productivity functionality of UVdesk ticketing system, which shows that how to create workflow to automate your help desk, how to create saved replies, and how to create different ticket types and tags as well. So let me take you to the backend configuration of the UVdesk help desk. As you can see, I am on the backend of UVdesk ticketing system, and here we will be checking out the functionality of productivity. So as you can see, we are having multiple options inside the same. The very first option is prepared response. Prepared response is something which is used to automate your help desk by setting some set of rules and conditions. As you can see, from here you can create a new prepared response. As here, I am going to create a new prepared response. The very first option, you need to fill out the name and description. And after that, you can make this particular prepared response as active or inactive. And after that, we are having an option of group. You can also assign this created prepared response into a specific group, as I am choosing here default group. And if you want to assign any team as well, then you can also do the same. And next, you will get an option of actions. From here, you need to set some actions so that this prepared response will work accordingly. As once you tap over this drop down, a list will come out from where you can select any one of them. As here I am selecting the option is set type as. If any ticket type is set as pre-sale query, then I am going to add another condition, that is assigned to agent. Means if any of the ticket type is pre-sale query, then that particular ticket will be assigned to the agent, and from here you can also set a specific agent. As here I am selecting the Alex. So once, if any of the ticket is having pre-sale query ticket type, then the ticket is automatically assigned to Alex. So this is the prepared response which I have created, and after that you need to hit over the save, and it will going to reflect over here. And once any of the ticket type coming from the pre-sale query, then that ticket will automatically assign to this user. Now next, we are having an option of saved reply. Saved reply is something which you can use for the common query ticket types, as you will get an option of creating a new saved reply. As here I am creating a new saved reply, that is new SR. Same here, you can assign this saved reply into a group. As here I am assigning the default group. And from here, if you have created any team, then you can assign this into the team as well. And here you can write down your content, like what information you want to provide to your customer for the common query ticket types. And after filling out the required information, you just need to tap over the save button, and you will get the particular saved reply into the list which we have created earlier. This way you can also create the saved reply and save the time of your support as well. Now next, you can see we are having an option of tags. Tags is something which you can assign to the particular ticket, as here I will going to show you on where you can able to add tags and where it will going to reflect. On the ticket view, you can see here inside the left navigation, we are having an option of tags. As here I am assigning a tag to this ticket, that is article, and accordingly a pop-up will come like success tag added successfully. And you can able to check the assigned tags into the left navigation of the ticket view page. Now coming back, I will going to show you. You can see we have created this tag, and this is assigned to a ticket. And if this particular tag is also assigned to any of the article, then the count will increase accordingly. So this way you can manage your tags over the ticket and articles. Now next, we are having an option of ticket type. Ticket type is something which will going to appear over the contact form. As here you will get an option of new ticket type. By hitting over there, you will get an option to add a new ticket type. As here, I am creating a new ticket type along with the code and description. And I am marking the ticket type as active or inactive from here. And need to hit over the save changes button, and you can see this will going to appear over the list. And I will going to show you where these ticket type will going to reflect over the knowledge base. As you can see, this is our knowledge base, and here you can able to find the contact us button, and here you will find list of ticket type, and you can also check the refund ticket type which we have created. So this way you can also add multiple ticket type to your contact page over the knowledge base. Now next we are having an option of workflow. Switching towards that, workflow is something by which you can set multiple events, actions and conditions, and accordingly it will going to perform actions with your UVdesk account helpdesk. As here you can see, we have multiple list of the created workflow, and I will going to show you like from where you can able to create new workflow. You will get an option of new workflow, and here you need to fill out the required information. As here I am creating a new workflow along with the name and description, and next you will get an option of marking this workflow as active or inactive. As here I am marking this as active, and the next option you will get events. As I have told you earlier, you will get some set of rules which you need to add over here, like the events, conditions and actions. So here I am going to add an event, that is customer. Like we are taking an example over here, like if a customer is created, then I need to choose the action. Like once the customer is created, then what action is going to perform over there? Then a mail to customer. See, as I have created this condition, like once a customer is created, then a particular email will be sent out to the customer along with the customer account created email template. And these email template you can create from the back end of UVdesk as per your own requirement. I will going to show you in the further videos like from where you can manage the email templates. So I have set this condition. Now I will going to save this workflow, and you can see the new workflow is successfully added along with a screen pop-up. So this way you can able to manage the productivity section, as we have covered here the prepared response, saved replies, tags, ticket types and workflow. So that's all about the productivity functionality of UVdesk helpdesk. In our upcoming videos, we will explore more features of UVdesk ticketing system. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.